Hello and good day. In this particular presentation, we will be discussing the penalty payable under Section 270A with regard to the incident of the underreporting and what are the subsequent consequences and the way out. Now, 270A levies a penalty for two reasons: misrepresentation and underreporting of the income. And we are going to discuss over here the underreporting of the income. And both are treated in a different manner. Because if it is an underreporting of the income, a person can even go for an immunity under the same section 270A. The SSC may not search for another immunity provision because 270A has got a time-bound response and which is much quicker than the other available section on the Act. Now let us understand what is the difference between the underreporting and the misrepresentation. So our focus today is on this underreporting, and whereby the illustrative list has been provided under the Act itself. And what is excluded at underreporting, that has been dealt separately, and the link of the same is available subsequently. With regard to the quantum of penalty, it is 50% of the amount of tax payable. Now let us understand what is considered as underreporting of an income. But before that, let us understand the process of the same. So let us understand the process. First, as a SSC files a return doing his own computation of his income. Subsequently, the department carry out any auto correction for the situation which has been provided under Section 143(1)(a), which will be taking up subsequently. After that auto correction, a notice is given to the SSC to pay the differential of the tax amount, and in that situation, no penalty is levied. Subsequently, the case may be selected for the scrutiny. Now, this scrutiny selection can be done on the random basis, or on the particular criteria basis, or subsequent to any information additionally available to them under Section 148. So in these three different scenarios, the case may be selected for the scrutiny. Once a case is selected for the scrutiny, the notice is being served to the SSC, and the SSC from time to time go on giving a response to the various queries which has been raised by the officer. Once all the response has been submitted, the officer will decide whether any addition has to be made to the income, because certain response he is not finding or willing to accept it. If that is the case, then he will pass an assessment order, which is known as an assess income, and he will determine the tax payable. Once that is being done, he will issue the penalty notice under Section 270A. Now, when this is done, subsequently the underreporting of the income has to be decided after going through the presentation of what is not considered as an underreporting of an income, which has been discussed separately. So, the underreported income over here means your assess income, which is more than your process income under Section 143(1)(a). So there is certain addition which has been done. If the return has not been filed, the assess income is a greater than the maximum income which is not chargeable to tax. That means the maximum income not chargeable to tax will be considered, plus this assess additional income will be added to the same. If the return has been furnished in accordance with the notice under Section 148A, because they got certain additional information, and then your case has been selected for the scrutiny, the assess income will be the greater than the maximum amount not chargeable to tax, or the income which you have declared under your income tax return on which the tax has already been paid. The assess income can be again reassessed, and that additional income also will be considered as an underreporting of an income. The arithmetical error which we had discussed under section 143(1)(a), so the errors which are automatically corrected by the department, first one is any arithmetical error in the written file or any incorrect claim which is apparent from the record that you are not entitled for that particular claim and you have claimed that as a deduction. Take for example, you are not paid the interest and you claim the same under the interest from the house property under the rent income, or the property you claim more than the limit which has been prescribed when the house property is a self-occupied property. So this correction will be automatically done by the department. Then there can be a disallowance of the losses if you are not filed your return in time and you claim the same disallowance as a brought forward and current in the current year you have adjusted against income, then the same also will be automatically corrected by the department. Or in your audit report, if certain expenditures are there and that expenditure has been disallowed by the auditor, but while you doing a calculation you have not done the same will be added to your income automatically under 143(1)(a). Or any other allowances deduction which you have claimed as specified on the screen and you have not filed the return, in that case also the department will automatically do the correction under 143(1)(a) and that will become the additional income. Now in certain cases, in the case of the company or the corporate body, the corporate company or the corporate body is required to pay a certain minimum amount of the tax which is known as a minimum alternative tax. It has to be paid on the book profit, and if it is a different, then the minimum alternative tax has to be paid. So in such a scenario, if your minimum alternative tax after the addition of the income is different, then that additional value will be considered as your additional unreported income. It can be the same scenario can be there in the case of the firm or the LLP. In all these cases, or if you have filed the return of the loss which turned to a positive income or the loss decreases, then that also will be considered as an additional income. But in this scenario, the additional income will be more than the maximum income not chargeable to tax. But in any case, as far as the company, LLP and the partnership firm is concerned, the minimum amount not chargeable tax is zero. It means that any additional done to your income, then that will be considered as an underreporting of the income, which will attract the penalty. Generally, that means if the adjustment is done before 143(1)(a), no penalty will be there. But any if your case is not gone through 143(1)(a) and it is selected for the scrutiny, in that case 143(1)(a) benefit not be available. So the tax payable has to be calculated by the SSC, which is given as follow. Now let us take an example to understand that in particular case you are not filed the return and you are a senior citizen for the financial year 2018-19. In that case, the return has not been filed, so your income is obviously not available or it is nil. Because return is not filed, order under 143(1)(a) cannot be passed, so your income is nil or not available. Now the income tax officer make an addition of 3 lakhs to your income. If you yourself would have declared 3 lakh as an income and the addition would have not been there, you would have not paid any tax because your tax liability being a senior citizen would have been zero. But because an addition has been made and you have not filed the return, for calculating the tax purpose, your income will be 3 lakh tax-free limit, that is a maximum amount not chargeable to tax, plus underreported income, that is 3 lakhs, so it will become 6 lakhs, and your tax payable will be 31,200. Your tax payable due to the addition to the income is 31,200. So 50% of this will have to be paid as a penalty. So 51% of 31,200, half the amount will be going as a additional penalty which you have to pay. Take another scenario. that you are a person who is filing a return and you are a normal citizen, you are not a senior citizen. You have filed a return of the income for 9 lakhs rupees. And according to your tax calculation, you have paid 96,200. Subsequently, the department made certain apparent correction as per the 143(1)(a), that five situation. And in that, they made it 10 lakhs. So they told you to pay the tax of 1,17,000 minus 96,200, the additional amount of the tax you have to pay along with the interest. But no penalty will be there. Now the same 3 lakhs has been added to your income. Added to the income of the return file, that is 9 lakhs plus 3 lakhs. So it become 12 lakhs. So on this 12 lakhs, tax payable comes to 1,79,400. But because already you have paid 1,17,000, so the additional tax payable on account of the underreporting of the income is 62,400, and you will have to pay the penalty to the extent of 50%, that is 31,200 you will have to pay in the form of a penalty. Now, once you receive the notice, you have got an option available to you. That once you get the notice, you have to decide, are you going to accept it or are you going to file an appeal? If you are going to file an appeal, then obviously no question of immunity being given or immunity question does not arise. But if you decide that I am not going to file an appeal, in that case you can go for an immunity. Immunity provided under section 270A related provision of the immunity. And that is much faster. So here, if you go for an immunity, you have to make an application. And if your application is accepted, obviously there will be no penalty. If your application is not accepted, then the proceeding continue. And if the penalty is not imposed, okay, no question of going further. But if the penalty is imposed, you have got an option to file an appeal also. Or you can go for an immunity. The provision of immunity we are going to deal with separately. So here, other related provisions which is affecting the same provision, that is 270A overall view, is a link has been provided and it is discussed separately. What is not under reporting and how you can save yourself from the penalty is provided and discussed under the separate presentation. Meaning of the misrepresentation and its consequence you can view in the next presentation. Penalty for the wrongdoing or not recording of the transaction 271AD, the link has been provided for the same and you can refer over there. And the immunity provision will be done and discussed subsequently.